one person or people under 30 doing amazing things to change the world. And I think this is our youngest young person who runs for the week, Adora Svitak, 9 years old, right? And our youngest author, a literary genius, you're called.
Yes.
Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
And so you wrote all of these books, and you've written so much more. Tell me about what you've written.
Well, I've written over 400 stories, some of them short, some of them long. I've also written over 200 poems, and I really love writing, and I'm continuing to write, and I hope to inspire other kids to read and write.
And I hear that you type really fast.
Yes, I type from 70 to 112 words per minute.
Wow. And what's your favorite thing to write?
I really love writing blogs, poems, stories, everything in stories, everything from fantasy to satire.
Okay, so let's read a little bit of what you've written. Here's one of your poems. If I drove an ice cream truck, it says, "Oh, if I drove an ice cream truck like Willy, Spoppy, Hillclimber, Top, I would have pennies and nickels and shiny dimes too, with a ton of employees, all with the food." You have an inspiration, Shel Silverstein. I can definitely hear that there.
Definitely, I love reading Shel Silverstein.
And tell me about some of the poems that you write. What inspires you? That's really advanced stuff.
Well, poems I think can be inspired by a lot of things. One of my poems is called "The Weeping Willow," and one day as I was walking, I just saw a weeping willow, and there it was. I should wait to live under the weeping tree. It was the first time. It just came to me at that moment. And then when I got home, opened my laptop, it just sort of sprouted from there.
And all of these things just sprout. I mean, is this more than one story you write a day?
Definitely. I write more.
not the end.
Definitely not. I'm right now in the process of publishing a book. Actually, it will be published in series, so it's called Dancing Fingers. It's a collection of my poetry. 100 to 150 poems, my best. And then I'll also have Yami's Guide, which is a political satire inspired because I watch CNN quite frequently.
Hold on. A political satire?
Yes, a political satire of the current administration. Like, there's one scene that kind of mirrors the conflict in the Middle East right now, where the my main character, Prince Elder, attempts to peacefully end the cooking oil debate in the town of Rowlett by saying to the villagers, "Oh, I'll find you alternative cooking oils," and he finds plants to make these cooking oils of, and manages to peacefully end the conflict.
So we're talking about President Bush here.
President Bush is Prince Elder's warlike father.
Amazing. Adora Svitak, our 9-year-old literary genius, no doubt. We should expand this table in a few years and we'll have many more books to show the world. And hopefully your message will go out there as well. Adora, thank you so much. Our youngest young person who rocks to date, 9 years old. Thanks, Adora.
Thank you.
And if you know anyone else who rocks out there, all you have to do is go to our website, cnn.com/youngpeoplewhorock.
Maybe do more international Asia tour, maybe just a short mention of Asia tour.
Do you want to redo the beginning?
Oh, no. Is it possible to insert that part, or is it already done?
Okay, we'll just